Reproduction is one of the many challenges faced by deep-sea animals. First, appropriate mates are usually few and far between and must somehow find each other in complete darkness. Then there is the question of what to do with the developing embryos to give them the best chance of survival. Among cephalopods, shallow water squids and cuttlefishes package fertilized eggs in a protective case and attach them to the seafloor, leaving them to develop on their own. Octopuses, on the other hand, brood their embryos in order to protect them from predators as well as keep them clean. In contrast, in the open ocean and deep midwater, there are no hard surfaces for cephalopods to attach eggs. Some open ocean squids release thousands of floating eggs, either individually or in huge gelatinous masses. The large number of eggs may overwhelm the appetites of predators, allowing some of the embryos to survive. This strategy is more difficult for deep-sea squids as they are generally food-limited and can't produce such large numbers of offspring. In recent years, submersibles have allowed scientists to explore the lives of deep-sea animals in ways that were not possible before. One of the many exciting discoveries was that a mother of the deep-sea squid species Gonatus onyx broods her eggs by holding them in her arms, a behavior that had never been previously reported for squids. We have now found another species, Bathyteuthis berryi, that broods a sheet of eggs in the water column, suggesting that this form of parental care may be a common solution to a reproductive problem for deep-sea squids. This female individual, a mere 10 centimeters or 4 inches long, was encountered at 1,350 meters depth, more than 3/4 of a mile below the ocean's surface. She is holding onto a single-layer egg sheet using small suckers near the base of her arms. The egg sheet contains about 360 embryos. Each embryo is 5 millimeters, or about 0.2 inches long, and rotates freely within its own capsule of the egg sheet. Carrying this egg sheet slows the female down during escape attempts, making her and her offspring more vulnerable to predation. But the benefits of caring for the young squid until they hatch must outweigh these risks. The female can determine the depth and therefore the temperature, salinity, and oxygen content of the water in which the embryos develop. Most importantly, she can protect them from becoming a tasty snack to the numerous deep-sea animals searching the water column for their next meal. This is Stephanie Bush from the Monterey Bay Aquarium Research Institute.